दिस इज सविता पवार, वेलकम टू माय चैनल गेट द मैप। दिस इज लेसन सिक्स, लाइंस एंड एंगल्स, सॉल्यूशंस फॉर लेसन सिक्स लाइंस एंड एंगल्स ऑफ एनसीईआरटी नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड। सो बिफोर दिस आई हैव अपलोडेड द वीडियोज ऑफ एनसीईआरटी स्टैंडर्ड एट्थ मैथ्स, यू कैन गो थ्रू द प्लेलिस्ट। सो फॉर नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड, नाउ स्टार्टेड फॉर द नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड, starting with lesson 6 lines and angles, let us see the solutions and the description here. First one is, this is the line segment. As you know, this is line segment ending with two end points. Then is the ray, which is having one end point, and on the one side it may increase, either this side or this side it may increase, that is called as the ray. This is the line. Line can be extended on both the sides, so the arrow is there on both the sides, that is called as a line. Then when two ray meet together, it forms an angle, and if the angle is of 90 degree, it is called as the right angle. If it is less than 90 degree, this angle, it is acute angle, which is less than 90. Then if it is more than 90, then it is called as the obtuse angle. Then if there is a bisector or any other line between the angle, whichever angle it is, so those two angles are called as the adjacent angles, which is having a common ray in between them, those are called as the adjacent angles. Then if the angle is of 90 degree, then two adjacent angles are called as the complementary angles to each other, as the sum of the complementary angle always is equal to 90 degree. Then the reflex angle. Reflex angle is always more than 180, that is called as the reflex angle. So this is called as a reflex angle. So, or whatever the angle is given, the rest of the angle minus 360 of this angle is called as the reflex angle. So, if you take A, B, C as this angle, so the reflex angle means of leaving this 90 degree, whatever is the remaining is called as a reflex angle. Then vertically opposite angle, if two lines meet each other at a point, then the angles formed in front of each other are called as the vertically opposite angles. And on a line, if there is a transversal and adjacent angles are there, then the sum of the adjacent angles on the straight line, whatever the number of the rays are there, if this is one here, it may be two or three like this, then the sum total of these angles will always be equal to 180 degree, as the base is the straight line. Okay, and the linear pair, it is also called as a linear pair, or it is also called as a supplementary angle. The angles whose total is 180 degree, it is also called as the supplementary angles. These two are one and the same thing. So this is all about the angles that you must know. Let us start with exercise 6.1 here. Now the first question is given as, lines AB and CD intersect at O. So these are the two lines, AB and CD intersect at point O here. If AOC, this one, and BOE, this angle that I have marked with yellow here, these two on adding get 70 degrees, and BOD, so this one with the red one, is 40 degrees, find the reflex angle of BOE. So BOE, reflex angle, okay, that you have to find, and COE, okay, so this one you have to find. You have to find BOE, this question mark, and the reflex of COE, this one, dotted line, black dotted line. So these two angles you have to find. So for this, the statements that you need to write are that AB is a straight line. AB is a straight line, then whatever is given, write that angle AOC plus angle BOE is given as 70 degree. Okay, so but as since this is a straight line, all this angle and this angle all total together will be equal to 180, सो ए ओ सी प्लस एंगल सी ओ ई प्लस एंगल बी ओ ई इक्वल टू 180 सिंस इट इज़ अ स्ट्रेट लाइन दैट वी हैव रिटन बट एज ए ओ सी प्लस बी ओ ई दैट दिस एंगल इज टोटली 70 द रिमेनिंग इज सी ओ ई इक्वल टू 180 सो दिस इम्प्लाइज एंगल सी ओ ई विल बी 180 माइनस 70 दैट गिवस 110 सो सी ओ ई दिस वन इज 110 ओके नाउ वॉट इज द रिफ्लेक्स फॉर सी ओ ई दे आर नॉट आस्किंग फॉर सी ओ ई दिस वन बट दे आर आस्किंग रिफ्लेक्स दिस ब्लैक डॉटेड लाइन सो फॉर दिस यू नीड टू फाइंड दिस मच फर्स्ट देन यू कैन फाइंड द रिफ्लेक्स सो रिफ्लेक्स एंगल सी ओ ई सब्ट्रैक्टेड विथ 360 माइनस 110 दैट गिव्स यू 250 सो 250 इज द रिफ्लेक्स एंगल सी ओ ई नाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड बी ओ ई सो नाउ बी ओ ई यू कैन सी दिस वन बी ओ ई हियर एंड दिस एंगल बी ओ डी सो बी ओ डी एंड दिस वन ए ओ सी यू कैन सी एक्स हियर सो दीज टू आर वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स सो एंगल ए ओ सी इज इक्वल टू एंगल बी ओ डी विच इज गिवन एज 40 द रीजन इज हियर वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स ओके देयरफॉर ए ओ सी हियर दिस विल ऑल्सो बिकम 40 बट सिंस दिस एंड दिस एंगल आर 70 सो वी कैन फाइंड बी ओ ई नाउ बट एंगल ए ओ सी प्लस एंगल बी ओ ई इक्वल टू 70 दैट इज गिवन सो दिस इज 40 ईयर प्लस एंगल बी ओ ई इज 70 सो एंगल बी ओ ई विल बी 70 माइनस 40 सो एंगल बी ओ ई इज 30 degrees. So this is the answer. This one and these two. These two are the required answers. Okay. The next one is line XY is given and MN is another line which intersects the line XY at point O. POY is given as 90 and these two angles are adjacent angles. It is given as A and B as 2:3. You have to find C here. Okay. So XY is a straight line XY is a straight line here A is to B is given as 2:3 whenever it is given in ratio you have to make it as an angle that multiplying with any variable as suppose x here and b equal to 3x okay let a equal to 2x and b equal to 3x okay and this one is 90 so all these three angles together will form as 180 therefore angle xom plus angle mop plus angle poy is equal to 180 since it xy is a straight line now xom is b here mop is a here poy is 90 equal to 180 now b value of b is 3x plus 2x plus 90 equal to 180 so add these two these are like terms so it becomes 5x and 180 take 90 this side so it becomes plus 90 equal to 180 so that gives 5x 180 minus 90 is 90 this implies x equal to 90 upon 5 is 9 ones and 4098 x equal to 18 so from this now you get the values of a and b so a is here angle mop that is a equal to a is 2x so that is 2 into 18 is 36 degrees. Then comes angle XOM. XOM is B here. B is 3x, is 3 into 18, that gives 54 degrees. Okay, now we want to find C here. So for to find C, you can see MN is also a straight line here. So if we subtract B a 180, B from 180, you get the C. It's simple. So MN is a straight line. MN is a straight line. And it includes two adjacent angles, that is XON and MOX. So angle XOM plus angle XON will give 180. Now XOM you have found out here 54 plus angle XON is 180. So angle XON, that is equal to C, equal to 180 minus 54, that gives you 126 degrees. So C equal to 126 degrees, that is the required answer. So this way you have to solve question number 2. Question number 3, this is a triangle given and they have said that these two angles are equal. Now what is the measurement that is not been given? Let us assume it as X here. Then prove that PQS, that is this angle, and PRT, that is this angle, these two angles are equal, that you have to prove. Okay, so now you have to write as ST is a straight line. ST is a straight line. Okay, so angle PQR plus angle PQS, this one PQR and PQS will be equal to 180. That is your equation number 1. The reason is linear pair. Okay, so let PQR is X here, PQR is X here, plus angle PQS equal to 180. So angle PQS equal to 180 minus X degrees. So let this be equation number 1. This is equation 1. Similarly on the other side, that is angle PRQ plus angle PRT equal to 180. That is also linear pair. So PRQ is X here. X plus angle PRT equal to 180. So angle PRT is also 180 minus X. That is equation number 2 here. Okay, so from equation 1 and 2 we can see both the angles are equal. So therefore from equation 1 and 2 we can see that angle PQS is equal to angle PRT, which was required to be proved, hence proved. Okay, so this statement was to be proved. The next one is here. In this equation, in this figure, this is a straight line. AB is a straight line here. So AB is a straight line. AB is a straight line here. And X, Y, W and Z are been given. X, Y are on the one side of the straight line AB, and Z and W are on the other side of the straight line AB. Okay. You have to prove that AOB is a straight line. You have to prove that this AOB is a straight line. Okay. So you have to prove that X and Y is equal to 180 and Z and W is also equal to 180. That should be proved. Now as you can see, this makes a whole circle here. So Okay, this need to be proved here. This is not given. So what we will write here as x plus y plus z plus w, total angle will be equal to 360, and it is also given as x plus y equal to z plus w. This thing has been given. Okay, now if you substitute this value in place of this equation, in place of z and w, you can substitute x and y. So x plus y plus x plus y equal to 360, it gives 2x plus 2y equal to 360. Take out 2 common, so x plus y equal to 360. That implies x plus y equal to 360 divided by 2, that gives 180 degrees. So since x plus y equal to 180 degrees, but x plus y is equal to z plus w, so z plus w will also be equal to, z plus w will also be equal to 180 degrees. Now since these two angles are equal to 180, these two are also equal to 180, therefore AOB is a straight line. Therefore AOB is a straight line, and that was to be proved, hence proved. So hence proved. So that was your question number 4. It's very easy, you have to just remember the straight line and its properties. Question 5 is POQ is a straight line, it is given, and a ray OR is perpendicular to PQ. OS is another ray lying between the rays OP and this one OR. You have to prove that ROS, this angle ROS, is half of QOS minus POS. QOS minus POS. Okay. Now you have to write it here as POQ is a straight line. Okay, now if it is a straight line, then all these three angles together will be equal to 180 degrees. So angle POS plus angle SOR plus angle ROQ is equal to 180 degrees. But we know that ROQ is given in the question as 90 degree. So POS plus angle SOR plus 90 equal to 180. Therefore POS plus angle SOR will be equal to 180 minus 90, that will be equal to 90 degree. So this whole is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so now from here SOR will be equal to 90 minus angle POS. Now let this be your equation number 1. Okay, now let us take ROS plus ROQ. Here angle ROS or SOR, one and the same thing. So angle SOR plus angle ROQ, okay, is equal to angle QOS. This one SOR plus ROQ equal to QOS, this thing. But ROQ is 90 in this also. So ROQ is 90. So angle SOR plus 90 equal to angle QOS. So angle SOR equal to angle QOS minus 90 degree. So this is your equation number 2. Now add these two things. This is also the equation for SOR. This is also the equation for SOR. This one and this one, both are the equations for SOR. Add those two things. So adding equation 1 and 2, so you will get as 2 times angle SOR will be equal to, add all the elements from the right hand side, इट इज 90 माइनस एंगल पी ओ एस प्लस एंगल क्यू ओ एस एंड माइनस 90. सो हियर इट इज प्लस 90 एंड माइनस 90. सो प्लस 90 माइनस 90 विल गेट कैंसल. दिस वन प्लस 90 एंड माइनस 90 विल गेट कैंसल. सो वॉट इज द रिमेनिंग? सो लेट मी राइट ऑन दिस साइड. So the remaining thing is 2 angle SOR will be equal to minus POS and this. So I will write the plus 1 before. So angle QOS minus angle POS. Now bring the 2 this side. So angle SOR equal to half and bracket angle QOS minus angle POS. This is your required equation. Okay, so this way you have to solve your question number 5th from exercise 6.1. Let us move on to question number 6. In question number 6, it is given x, y, z is 64. X, y is produced to P further. So it is a straight line. It is produced to P further. Then y, q is a bisector of z, y, P. Okay, so x, y is a straight line here. X, y is a straight line. It is not given directly, it is a straight line. Okay, so from all the angles together it becomes 180. So angle XYZ plus angle ZYQ plus angle QYP is equal to 180. Now in this equation, in this question, it is given as YQ is a bisector. It bisects this angle ZYP. So bisector means equal half. So these two angles are equal, that I have shown with cross. So these two are equal and this one is 64. So let this be x here. This is 64 plus x equal to 180. So 64 plus 2x equal to 180. So this implies 2x equal to 180 minus 64. That gives you something. (116/2) to get the value of x, you have to find it becomes 58. Okay, so x is 58 here. Now x is what? Either this angle, both are 58 here. Okay, so that will be your, this will be equal to angle ZYQ equal to angle QYP. These both are equal to 58 here. Now you have to find the reflex angle of QYP. So reflex angle of QYP with the red I have shown, that is you should subtract it with 360 degrees. So reflex angle QYP equal to 360 minus 58. So that will give you 302 degrees. That is the reflex angle QYP. Okay. Now the next one is XYQ. You have to find XYQ also. This one XYQ, it is a combination of these two are the adjacent angles. So it is 64 plus X. So angle XYQ is equal to XYZ plus ZYQ. XYZ plus ZYQ. Now this is 64 and this is 58. So angle XYQ is equal to 122 degrees. Okay. So this way you have to solve your exercise 6.1. If you have any query, you can comment me on the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe my channel, Get the Math.